Hello everybody, today I'm going to be going over my Kenny Hack Juice. This stuff here is a homemade staining product that from what I find is probably the best pre-treatment for wood that for laser work. It basically doubles to triples your speed at which you can burn images. I'll be kind of going through showing some demo boards, a live demo, kind of, and then at the end go over how to make this stuff. This stuff is no top secret recipe of my own. It's actually something that is used by a lot of woodworkers in hobby crafts. I've just recently discovered on how well this stuff works for lasers, by far better than any other product I've found. So let's get to it. So here's the setup. We got a 4x6 piece of just 1/8 inch thick pine plywood. Just use these as demo pieces. In the first area, there has no treatment applied. Second area has white watercolor painted over it. Third area has my stain as the bottom coat with white watercolor painted over the top of that to lighten it up. And the fourth area is just my stain. Gonna be burning a grayscale from black to white. You can see it's set up at 5,500 millimeters per minute. Max speed on these diode lasers is 6,000. Set at 80% power. The line interval is 0.15, which is kind of a average setting. Gonna play, let it burn for a little while in the first area, see how it does. Move the piece to the next area and work my way across, and hopefully we'll see what the results turn out. You can see it's not really even touching the bare wood at this speed. Usually have to run at about 1200 millimeters per minute, 70 to 80% power to get a good burn and bare wood for a diode, a 20 watt diode. Let's try the next area. Not burning anything. The white watercolor usually makes it worse than bare wood. That white watercolor reflects the light more, kind of stops it. Let's go to the third. You can see here, it's already starting to burn in. Even with the white watercolor added over the top of it, it's getting a fairly good transition from black to nothing. There is still room to add more power, so if you wanted it a hair darker, it easily could go a little darker. Here's just my plain stain. You can see now you're getting a really good full-length transition from black to almost all the way to the end. It's where it's coming up white, it's still dithering in a little bit of color, so it's almost too dark of a setting. We probably could turn the power down to 70% or speed it up to the max speed, 6,000. And this is pretty typical with any kind of wood I've tried this on. So nothing in the areas where it's been just no stain or white watercolor added. With the stain and white watercolor, those are just about the right settings for doing picture quality. If it was just the bare stain, it's probably a hair on the dark side. It could be sped up to max speed or turned down about another 10%. It'd be about perfect. This here is another demo board I made up. It was done at 4,500 millimeters per minute and 70% power. This is a regular golden oak stain. It kind of got the darker side of the gradient, but lost power pretty quick. Natural oak stain pretty much didn't help or hurt. It pretty much almost comes up the same as bare wood. Here's a walnut stain. It's like I said, it catches the dark end of the range, but loses the focus pretty loses the power pretty quick. That strip has no treatment. You can see it's barely burning. Wouldn't really be good for much of anything at that speed and that power for a diode. But where I applied my stain, more than plenty dark enough. I was actually able to smudge that so it was still a hair dark. So a little more speed or a little less power, either one would work. So here's what everybody wants to know. How to make this stuff. This is not a formula I've come up with. This is something that's been used by woodworkers, by craftspeople for a long time. It's not really any big secret to it. This is kind of a new hack of how to use it. You know, all this mixture is some cleaning vinegar. You can use white distilled vinegar. Even apple cider vinegar works, not as effectively, but it does work on wood. Some steel wool, and then just a storage can. Take your vinegar, fill your can about half full, add in a little chunk of steel wool, like one pad's worth. You'll throw it in the can, let that sit in the can for about 4 or 5 days. Occasionally you're going to want to come by, stir it up. This will build pressure in here, so be careful when you're stirring it. You might want to first crack the lid and vent the pressure off. Reseal it. This vinegar will start to dissolve the steel wool and oxidize it. Just basically turns it into rust. And even if your steel wool is not completely dissolved after 4 or 5 days, leave that piece of steel wool in there. It will eventually dissolve it all. But after 4 or 5 days, it should have dissolved enough and oxidized enough that you can take this, if you're half full, fill the rest of the way up with water. So this is about a 50% dilution. And you can apply this to any kind of wood. It has different effects on different wood. This stain is primarily used as a wood ager. It's used to artificially speed up the aging process of wood. Some woods like pine, it doesn't work very well, but it will slightly turn into like a slight tan. Some woods, it'll get to a light gray to even a dark gray and sometimes black if you put enough layers on it. It's like I said, you can find all kind of videos on how to make an aging stain. I have no idea who originated this. It's been around in woodworking forever. I just kind of stumbled on this hack. I use this product for a lot of things. And I started burning stuff on there and was just amazed how much better these diode lasers work with this stain. I mean, it's a game changer. It's 4 or 5 times faster that you can burn your images with these diodes. You're up to maximum speed with these things. And it's a good deep burn. It's black as you can get it. And I haven't found anything that comes close to as well as this product works. So this is just kind of like a hack. Like I said, I thought about trying to market this and make up batches to sell, but that just seemed like it'd be a nightmare. This is, I've dug through all YouTube trying to see if anybody is using a process like this. I honestly can't find anybody else that has a pre-treating chemical that they use for laser work that works this well, or that anybody is using. I don't see it getting used in any videos. So I decided just to get this thrown out there, kind of more as a friendly hack. I just ask that if you use this process on any of your projects and you're posting it on YouTube, I just ask that you add a link to my video, kind of as the originator of the hack. If you know of somebody else that has shown something like this before, let me know. I'll give them full credit. I have never seen anybody using it, but just getting credit for kind of coming up with this, kind of call it the Kenny hack. Just getting credit for it will be enough for me. Hopefully I can get enough likes and shares of this video. Whatever little bit I might get back from YouTube, that would sure be wonderful. Until then, hope everybody, you know, use this at your own risk. I've only been doing this for like a month. I haven't tried every kind of wood there is, but everything I've tried it on, it's worked well. I haven't tried it on canvas to see if you can treat canvas to help it burn better on that. I don't know if that'll work. I don't know how dilute you can make this product to where it's only 10% strength or 25% strength and still get good results. That's some more experimenting to do. I just hope this kind of helps everybody, especially the diode users who or have to usually run really slow to get decent quality. I think this is a big game changer for everybody, and I really hope this hack I found helps everybody out. Thank you. More information to add is this stuff, as you can see, is pretty corrosive on metal cans. It probably actually better to put this in an old plastic container. This might be a little less messy. Kind of every time you pop the lid, a little bit of the rust kind of flakes around, and it's probably just going to get messier as it gets concentrated more. I think kind of the secret to this recipe is the iron oxide. That rust is what's making the laser work so much better. Hope to do a little more experimenting, maybe get my hands on some powdered iron oxide, mix that in with some regular stains, see if that helps make any stain a better laser useful friendly product. I'm pretty new to the lasering world. I have kind of as a precaution, I don't know any of the long-term effects of running your laser over this, if it's gonna damage it in any way. I've been using it for a month on mine, haven't had any problems, but you do have to use this at your own risk. It's a huge time saver, will change the game up for you diode users on how fast you can get stuff done, where you'll be running at near 100 millimeters per second, as fast as these machines can go. So, I mean, it's a game changer, but the long-term effects of it, I don't know yet. Like I said, please like and share. And if you use this method and this hack, just kind of calling it the Kenny hack, it's my name. Share this, link this to your video. Kind of try to give me some credit for it if you can. I hope to see a lot of other people being able to use this and really make some wonderful products with it. All right, thank you.